Hello! This video in the Capstone video series will help you to better understand what to include in your final capstone paper. Your final capstone paper is a reflective paper, not a research paper, and will be a total of 10 to 12 pages double-spaced. The purpose of this paper is for you to reflect on how your capstone project ties back to your coursework, as well as the competencies that you outlined in your original capstone project proposal, including the competencies that you brought to the project, as well as the competencies that you gained from the project. One of the biggest tips we can give you is to not wait until the last minute to write your capstone paper. Be aware of the deadline and plan accordingly. One of the most efficient ways to write your paper is to write it while you're working on other final capstone assignments, such as your poster and your presentation, since you'll be using some of that information in your paper. As previously mentioned, the capstone paper is meant to be 10 to 12 pages in length. This paper should be broken up so that the first section that describes your capstone project to the reader is about 3 to 4 pages long. The remaining 6 to 8 pages then cover the relationship between your project and your previously outlined competencies, as well as any relevant coursework that you've completed. You'll be able to view the grading rubric for this paper in Canvas. Some of the questions to address in your paper may include what the public health importance was of your project, what the importance is to you of the competencies that you selected, what you took away from the MPH experience, including activities within and outside the classroom, and how your capstone project and the presentation of your work helps you toward becoming a better public health professional. As a reflective paper, we want you to be thoughtful in your writing. We want you to see this as an opportunity for you to reflect on your time in the MPH program, where you started and where you are now, areas where you've grown, and how you see yourself shaping into a public health professional. This reflection process can also be helpful for you in thinking about how you list and describe your public health skills on your resume and in interviews as you prepare to join the public health workforce. This is the last video in the MPH Capstone video series. Remember that you can go back to review other videos at any point in time as you work on different stages of your capstone project. And, as always, be sure to reach out to your faculty advisor with any questions or challenges.